The estuary itself we're talking about in Lower Glenelg National Park is the Glenelg River estuary. It extends for some 75, 76 kilometres upstream towards Dartmoor. We're surrounded by the Southern Ocean to the south of us, and to the north of us we have huge expanses of pine plantations and blue gum plantations and productive farming lands. We're not far from the major port of Portland, and we're also very close to the small seaside town of Nelson, which is a very, very popular fishing destination, tourist destination. There is a number of species here and a component of ecosystems here that are still here after years of management in the catchment by us. And I guess what we're seeing here is that those species are still coexisting and those wetlands are still functioning as they were meant to function, and coexisting with the productive landscape that we have, with the forestry and with the grazing enterprises that are close by. And to me, that's an important thing. That's the balance that we're trying to reach with natural resource management.
We've been working with quite a lot of landholders over the last 16 years as part of the Glenelg River Restoration Project. The aim of that project has been trying to address a lot of the threats to the Glenelg River. We've worked with almost 700 individual landholders, and we do that through what we call a partnership program. So we provide funding to landholders for fencing their waterways, doing weed control, and also revegetating as well.
I've been farming here since 1998. The Victorian side's 1,350 acres, I think, and the South Australian side's not quite 900. It's pretty unique. It's got three springs that run through it, so we've got permanent water all the time. With the springs and that, we have a huge amount of water running out into the river there every day, which is obviously very, very good for the river. We've fenced off tree areas and that sort of thing, which I think the CMA are pretty happy with that, so that the stock don't damage them and whatever else.
Landholders really get on board with our programs because they can see the benefits in terms of production for them as well. For example, by fencing off their waterways, they can manage their stock a lot better. They can also reduce stock losses, and also we're providing them with alternative water, so they actually can improve stock health as well. We've done some work recently in terms of what value that actually has on the Glenelg itself, and we've been able to estimate it's about $130 million that it's contributed to production values along the Glenelg River to those landholders. The Glenelg River Restoration Project's not just working with landholders, it's also working with a whole lot of different agencies over public land, but also on other private landholders such as plantation industry.
Green Triangle Forest Products has around 6,500 hectares to 7,000 hectares in this region of pine trees. And in addition to that, we've got another 500 hectares of other land that we manage in and around the pine trees. Our holding here is all within 5 kilometres of either the Discovery Bay Coastal Park or the Lower Glenelg National Park. And we've got around 40 kilometres of shared boundaries with those parks. So we're sort of sandwiched between the coast and the Lower Glenelg National Park. We've got lots of integrated little patches of bushland in this area in particular, near the Discovery Bay Coastal Park, which we conserve as part of managing our land in this area. Animals in particular that move between our areas of conservation reserve and the surrounding parks probably gives them greater conservation value because they're linked in with that bigger landscape park area that's adjacent to them. Probably the biggest issue for us with growing pine trees in this area is fire. And so managing fire breaks between us and the parks area is really important to us. We work with neighbours in lots of other ways. Controlling noxious weeds is an important one. Controlling feral animals is really important too. And we see ourselves not as something separate to this community, but as part of this community. Cooperation is probably the key thing on the issues that affect us all.